Hello people of the internet, welcome back. In this video I'm going to talk about something that I haven't really spoken about online, but it's a thing and it's been a thing for a very long time. Well, not that long, but like since I had my hearing loss, this has been a significant issue. And that is my eye problem caused by my ear problem. And it's called, the technical name is Oscillopsia, I think that's how you say it. It's got a C in it, but I don't think that's pronounced. It's either oscillopsia or oscillopsia, I guess would be how you'd pronounce it. I think it's oscillopsia. Basically, that's where the reflex that allows your eyes to stay still while your head to move is lost. And that's because of the balance function in my ears has like gone. It's like dead. So basically how this presents itself is when I'm like walking along, I can't keep things stable. So as my head moves up and down as I walk, everything looks like it's going like this. As my head moves, everything kind of jumps up and down because my eyes are moving with my head rather than, for example, like if you don't have oscillopsia, you can look at like a fixed point and then turn your head and continue looking at that fixed point. Whereas for me, that's, I have to really, really focus to like turn my head and continue. I have to like manually do it. It's not something that I can just like, if I'm doing, yeah, I can't do it. And that's something that is surprising, has a surprising amount of impact, because it sounds so minor, like, oh yeah, you can't keep your eyes still while your head moves. It's a big deal. Like, it's really hard for me to exercise because I get motion sick. And when I first lost my hearing and this first kind of became an issue, even walking, I would get motion sick. Now I'm okay walking, as long as I'm not like looking at one fixed point for too much, then I'm fine. But running, I can't really run for any amount of time. Like, I mean, I can like jog, like I can gently run to like get to the bus stop or something, like if it's only like 100 meters or something, I'm fine. But like, not, I can't like, oh, go for a run because of my eye thing. I just get motion sick. I'm trying to build it up. So I was given by the auditory implant center, because I know they're like, their main thing is cochlear implants, but they also provide, they provided me with this for some reason once it was established that my balance was really affected, which, I mean, it didn't take long to establish that. They gave me some exercises to do, which are a lot of like what I was showing, like practicing, like balancing your brain and your eyes, like learning how to compensate for that. Which has been really helpful. Like now, as I was saying, I don't get motion sick from walking. What a bonus. And I'm starting to include other things. Like, I haven't done a lot of exercise for quite a while because, well, until relatively recently. A, because I was so tired all the time, because I was relying purely on my cochlear implant. I didn't have interpreters in my classes or anything, and I was learning to lip read. It wasn't good. I had no energy to do anything, and also because I would just get so sick, like even from walking, I'd feel awful, like properly seasick, like. And so now I'm trying to build that up. Like, now I've been doing these exercises for like 2 years, and I think I've kind of got it about as good as it's going to get. I'm still trying to build up. So now I do Zumba once a week. I do a step exercise class, you know, like one of the ones where you've got like a little step and you go on and off. And I do yoga once a week when I can get on to the class at the gym, because sometimes that's impossible. I also have like resistance bands, and I do like resistance band exercises every day, which for a while that was the only exercise I could do, the resistance bands, and just keep my head still and like only do things that I could do with my head still. But now I can do Zumba, which is like jumping around, and for some reason that's absolutely fine. But the other day, like about a a week ago, I don't know, it doesn't matter the exact day, but I tried going to the gym on my own because I couldn't book onto an exercise class. They were all booked up, all the ones I wanted to do anyway. And I had to, well, I didn't have to, but I decided like, oh, I'll just walk on a treadmill, going like on an incline, like a maximum incline, you know, at a decent speed for 30 minutes. And I thought that would be fine. No, I got off that and I was like, nope. No, I felt okay when I was doing it. And then as soon as I stopped, I was like, whoa, no. Which I would never have thought that would have been an issue. Like, I can do Zumba fine. I think it was because the treadmill had like a screen in front. So I was kind of looking at the screen. And I think trying to focus my eyes on that while walking is what caused it. So yesterday I was like, okay, I'll go back again and I'll try something slightly different and see if I can do that in the gym and not have a problem. So I did cross trainer and that seemed to be better, but I only did it for 20 minutes and I was being very, very gentle with it. I was making sure not to look at the screen and I, you know, every kind of 5, 10 minutes, I don't know, I would stop, just give myself a sec, make sure I wasn't feeling sick, and then carry on and do it like another 5 or 10 minutes, which is a bit unusual, I think, for someone, because I'm 23, in case people didn't know, so I'm quite young, I'm relatively fit, like I'm not an athlete by any stretch of the imagination, I've always been like the clumsiest person on the planet. But yeah, it's really, really limiting, this oscillopsia thing. So yeah, and another thing that I can't do was my balance problems. If someone's walking next to me and trying to talk to me, I really struggle to like turn my head to look at their lips while walking forward, because that throws my balance off, because my balance is so reliant on my eyes. Yeah, I really struggle to walk, like trying to cross a street as well. I can't look left and right while I'm walking. I have to stop, look, and then look forward and walk. I can't like keep looking while I'm walking. Also reading street signs, I have to literally stop and then read the street sign, because if I'm walking, everything looks like it's going like that and I can't read it. And this is really weird because I have, my eyesight's fine. I mean, it's not great. With glasses, I just meet the legal driving limit. So I have like 20, 40 vision or 6, 12, whatever. It doesn't really matter. But that's what my vision is like. So it's not bad. It's not great either, but it's not that bad. I can drive. But for some reason, yeah, I've got this weird bobbing, eye bouncing issue. And that actually affects my life quite a lot. So yeah. Hopefully if you have that experience as well, some people get it after they get cochlear implants or have, but they have balance issues after they get cochlear implants because the cochlear implant can like damage the balance system or something, but I had it before. Let me know if you've had this experience and what you think about it. Thank you very much for watching and I will see you in my next video. Bye.